What's up, everybody? This is Smokey from the Lowrider Connection, and we're heading south to Lakewood, Colorado to check out the homeboy Adrian's badass 61 Impala and a few of his other rides. So stay tuned.
What's up, bro? Is this your bike?
Yeah, that's my bike.
Wow, bro. It's a badass bike, bro. Love that gray.
No, thanks.
Did you do the upholstery on the seat?
Yeah, we did that here.
Killer, bro. So what you got going on here, bro?
57 hardtop I'm building right here.
Oh, wow.
64 I'm doing for a buddy. 58 on the rack. My buddy Eddie's from Click.
Man, you got a lot of big time cars in here, bro. Got a drop.
Yeah, we stay building these Chevys.
This is the upholstery shop, bro?
Yeah, this is the upholstery room.
Wow. What a nice.
These seats down for a 60 right now.
Damn, killer work, bro. Look at that shit. Shout out to your upholstery guy, bro.
Yeah.
Nice, bro. Then you got this rag right here.
64, it's coming out this summer,
yep.
64
Super
Sport.
Fuck yeah. And then you got
5.0, my buddy's wife's in there.
Oh, you got a 5.0, huh?
Yeah, my buddy's wife, she always wanted a 5.0 on 17.9, so he's, you know, she's making it happen.
Damn, dope. Got a deuce back there?
Yeah, I can take you next door if you want to check it out.
Oh, you got more here?
Oh,
wow, bro. Yeah, I'd love to check it out, bro. So, YouTube, what you got going on here? All right, sounds good, bro. Just a normal day out here in Colorado. Adrian out here just hanging out. He got all his badass rides. He got some of the homies' rides. What's up, fellas? How you guys doing?
What up?
We guys want to send a shout out to everybody on YouTube from Denver, Colorado. This is room two, building two. Oh damn, bro.
Right here.
Look at that. Damn, you got some beautiful stuff in here, man.
60 right here, building for a homie one. Shh. 78 coupe.
Yep. Whose is this one, bro?
That's one of mine.
One of yours?
Yeah, nice. That's one of mine. I'm just messing around with right now.
Yeah, bro, you got a lot of space over here, bro.
Yeah.
And then you got one in the booth, huh?
Yeah, I got a 55 Chevy right here. We just jammed out. Buddy of mine, Jerry.
Oh, wow, look at that color, bro. It's like a gunmetal gray.
Gunmetal gray, yeah.
Oh, beautiful. Damn, bro, you got a lot of shit going on here. That's what's up, Adrian. Doing big things, man. From paint to upholstery, this dude will have you fucking set up right.
Trying to make people's dreams come true right here.
So you are, bro. Wow. And this is just one of the buildings. You still have another building too, right?
Yes, sir, yep. Down the street, 3615 Morrison Road.
Damn. What's up, everybody? This is Smokey from the Lowrider Connection, and we're out here in Lakewood, Colorado, connecting with Adrian Cisneros. What's up, bro? How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good, bro. Thanks for letting us stop by your shop, bro, and checking out all the badass rides.
Yeah, anytime.
So, bro, what made you get into lowriding? About what age did you get into lowriding?
And I would say probably since I was playing with Hot Wheels, you know?
Yeah.
Messing around with them Hot Wheels and drilling out the rivets to switch the wheels around and shit on the bottom of them.
Oh, you were one of those guys, yeah, huh? Yeah. That's what's up, bro. And then you probably got into model cars and stuff like that.
All that stuff, man. I remember doing all that. And just, you know, I lived on Kentucky and about Kentucky equipment. So back in the 90s, like, everybody was from Sheridan to Kentucky, you know, or from Sheridan to Federal on Kentucky. Rather was turning around or going this way, going that way, and just seeing all the cars, man.
You just saw the cars and
yeah. Like,
one day I'm going to get Bobby myself
hooked, yo.
A lowrider. And what was your first car, bro?
My first car, I'm going to say I had an 84 Cutlass. 84 Cutlass I bought, and it was wrecked.
Uh-huh.
We put it together, and I think Dean painted the front clip for me and blended it, and we got it going on the road.
Wow, and is that Dean Apodaca?
Dean Apodaca, yo.
And a lot of people, if you know your Colorado lowrider history, Dean Apodaca used to have a 6.4 that killed it back in the day in the game. Smile Now, Cry Later?
Yep, Smile Now, Cry Later. I grew up hanging out at his garage back in the day, you know.
Wow, what a mentor.
All those guys like Chato and all them dudes, you know, just watching all them dudes work on cars, it just inspires you, you know.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Man, what a cool childhood growing up knowing these guys, man, you know.
Yeah, just riding your, you know, pedal bike to his garage, go watch him wheel that car. I actually watched him when he used to cruise it too before that, you know.
Oh damn, so you've seen all stages of that car.
Yeah, for sure.
That's what's up, man. What made you get into the automotive and paint business?
I was in the window tint business and tire wheel business in like 2008 when everything kind of crashed. I wasn't making no money, you know, because it was a luxury, you know, window tint and tires and wheels was a luxury, and it was like the market crashed, and I was like, man, I gotta do something else, because I gotta do something people actually need, you know, so everybody's in car accidents all the time, and getting in collisions, getting in wrecks, you know, I was like, I need something like that where people actually need it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Rather than, you know, window tint and wheels was a luxury, so I was just like at a dead point right there. So I went on, I got the opportunity to come in the shop, and that's what I did.
Wow, it's an amazing story, man. You gotta survive, man, definitely. So what year did you purchase a 6.1 Impala, and where did you get it from?
Say 2019, I bought it from a buddy, Martin, and he actually made payments on it, you know. I didn't have all the money and break him off little bread here and there, you know. Mm-hmm. And he was cool with that, so
yeah.
You know, for over the years I repainted it, redone the whole car, interior, top, everything, you know. It's always doing something to it, you know. One thing about this is you're never done, you know, especially when you're out here rolling, you know, you just, the top fades or, you know, you want to keep going, keep moving on it, you know, keep getting inspired by other stuff. And
yeah,
I want to do this now, I want to do that now, I want it to drive good, especially because I'm all over the place with it, you know.
You are, bro. And one thing about you, bro, you cruise your cars.
Oh yeah, yeah, that's one thing that I build it to cruise, you know?
Yeah, no matter what's done to it underneath.
Yeah.
No matter the quality of the car, you're out there, you know, strolling that shit, rolling.
Yeah, different states everywhere, you know?
Yeah. So on the 6.1, man, what was the original motor? What was the original motor? And then what did you put in?
It had a 283 with the Power Glide.
Mm-hmm.
I ended up doing an LS platform out of like a wrecked, I think it was an 02 Corvette that I bought, and we took the engine out and put in a transmission out of a 4L60 two-wheel drive.
Oh, fuck.
so I had to overdrive, you know. But I definitely like it because it's reliable and it doesn't leak all over, and I could get on the freeway anywhere, you know.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
So when you got the car, man, did you have to repaint the car? Was the body work pretty good, or what was the condition of the car?
It was fairly original. It was an older restoration, but the car's probably had 3 paint jobs since I've had it, you know.
And always, is it always been red?
It's always been red. Yep, I changed up the red a little bit.
Nice. And I see you got that gangster back window, man. Is that something that you put on the car?
Yes, it was. Yep.
Nice.
And they came out with the slotted ones. I wanted the slotted ones. So.
It's a clean car, man. What kind of chroming and modifications you done underneath the car? Like, who lifted the car when you got it?
So originally, I was out in California, and I was at my buddy Topo's shop, TS Designs. Everyone knows him as White Body King. I was out there, and I was going to Arizona next weekend, and he's like, "Hey, Adrian, you know that ain't a lowrider, right?" And I said, "Man, why are you saying that, Topo?" He said, "I said it's low to the ground, man." He goes, "But it's not a lowrider till it's lifted, man." And I was like, "Man, I just like cruising it, and I don't have time to go leave it at shops for 3 weeks, months, and
right.
be without a car, you know."
Mm-hmm.
And he said, "Man, I'm gonna do you a solid right now, man. You want to roll to Phoenix lifted?" I said, "Yeah, hell yeah, you know." I go, "You got someone?" He said, "Hell yeah, I got someone." And you know, he called up Anthony Fuentes from Homies Hydraulics.
Oh wow.
Southside Car Club, you know.
Yeah.
And he's like, "Look, we're gonna take your car in the morning, and by dinner time, it's gonna be juiced, ready to go, you know." And I'm like, "You serious, man? Let's go then. Let's do it, you know."
Mm-hmm.
So we took it to the shop next day in the morning. And then sure enough, by dinner time, I was rolling on hydraulics with, you know, breaking stress points reinforced, you know, extended uppers, you know, nice lay and play.
Wow.
And then I redid the car. I had a frame built. I redid it. And then this time around, San Mondragon did all the hydraulic work under. We redid everything because I wanted a three-wheel and have fun now that I had a, you know, wrapped frame.
Of course.
So I had San Mondragon from getting up hydraulics in the trunk, and Lowrider G and let's see what part of California is that. And I don't remember what California. Lowrider G built my frame though.
Wow.
In California.
You got a lot of big names on this
full
car.
Frame. Yeah, for sure. For sure. Big and I appreciate names. All the help from them, you know.
Yeah, man.
They always open up their doors to me when I'm out of town and stuff, so you know, that's the good part about going all over, you know, getting to know good people.
Yeah, building those relationships.
For
bro.
Sure.
And how many pumps and how many batteries?
It's got 3 pumps, 8 batteries right now.
And it has a little kick to it, huh?
Oh yeah, I have fun with it.
Yeah. I see you having fun with it.
Yeah.
And who reupholstered the rag on it?
We did it all here.
At your shop?
Yep, we did the rag over again. We did the seats here, the carpet.
Everything.
It's got 64 inserts.
Oh, wow.
64 Impala inserts, you know.
Yeah. Can you tell us a little bit about your business that you own?
So I own Choice Auto Body here in Lakewood. Originally, all I wanted to do was insurance work. But it got boring to me, you know, and the best part about it is I could work on my own cars, you know, when we're slow, or we could get everybody on them before I'm ready for a show and improve them, you know,
mm-hmm.
or when I'm getting ready to go out of town, we all get together and work, and the guys don't, you know, the guys are cool. Shout out to my employees because they're never crying about overtime or nothing on all the late nights and stuff, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, you guys put out some quality work. I've seen a lot of your work and super quality. And you guys do paint and interior as well, right?
Yep, paint and upholstery.
Wow.
That's... paint and upholstery, a lot of mechanic work too.
Wow, service the neighborhood. And you kind of been in this neighborhood, this side of town for pretty much your whole life, right?
Yeah, my whole life. I grew up right here in Westwood, so yeah.
And it's changed a lot. It's changed a lot.
But, it has.
But it still has, it's kept its culture.
But it's around still here. Only one of the only hoods left.
It is. Know? Yeah, you're right.
It's one of the only hoods left. Yep. That hasn't been gentrified or, you know.
Yep. And about how many employees do you have in your shop here?
There's a total of about six of us.
60. Yeah. Nice. So big question for you, man, because you're everywhere from state to state. And where do you see Colorado lowriding headed?
I definitely see a lot of people like stepping up their game. I'd like to see it more, but over the years it's been trending a lot more, you know. I'm hoping that to see us be like, you know, Phoenix or California one day, you know, and have some fun and cruise, you know, get out there and cruise. That's one thing I like doing.
Yeah, cruising.
I just feel like that no one cruises unless someone puts out a flyer, you know, like, or somebody sets it up, you know. It's like, it used to be automatic, you know, everybody knew what to do.
Yeah.
But now it's like, someone has to put out a flyer or say, we're all going to be at Berkeley, and then everybody shows up. Instead of like, let's all go to Berkeley just automatically, or let's all cruise the boulevard automatically, you know?
Yeah.
Federal's kind of fucked up now.
It is.
Excuse my language.
No, but, it is.
You know, there's still Broadway. There's still other strips we can go take over and have some fun. And I'd really like to see that for sure.
I totally agree with you, man. You know, cruising. I mean, kicking it and sitting in parking lots, that's cool for a minute. But I like to cruise, bro.
Yeah.
I like to get out there and enjoy the music and...
That's what it's about. Yeah, yeah, that's the therapy of it, you know.
It is, bro.
Getting in your car and riding, you know.
Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure you've had some rough days, bro, at
for
work.
Sure, we all have, man.
And you get in your car, drop just the top.
Get in your car.
And dip.
Take the long way home, you know.
Just, oh, yeah.
Or just go cruise around. You're not going nowhere, really, you know.
Yeah.
My family will jump in the car, you know. My son grew up in cars. My daughter now loves it, you know. My wife, she does whatever, you know, she's always supportive, so we jump in the car and we're doing nothing, we're driving around, but it's fun, you know?
Yeah.
We have fun doing it.
And you're making memories.
Yep, and in the winter times when we can't do it, we're missing it, you know? So the first time we could get away, rather it's out of state or here, we get in that car and roll, you know?
Yeah, and see, that's one thing good about Colorado in a way. It kind of sucks, I mean, though, that the weather goes kind of bad, but we have that time to build our rides up.
Yeah,
we step do. Up your game. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And I think we need to focus on that a little bit more in the wintertime.
Oh, I agree. I agree that for a lot of cars out there, you know.
But, yeah.
And it's hard, and I understand it's expensive and everything, but when you're passionate about something, you find a way. You know what I mean? I don't got all the stuff I got for nothing because I didn't hustle my way, or late nights going home from work, or selling one car, or trading three cars for one, or doing stuff like that, or fixing wrecked cars, or anything to sell them to buy another car, or asking buddies, hey, can you work with me a little bit, you know, make a couple payments, you know. I found my way, and, you know, now I'm kind of, I love it. I'm living what I always wanted to do, you know. I live my dream, you know.
Yeah. So what is your dream car? Because I'm pretty sure you already own it.
Probably that 63 outside, you know, 63 convertible. 63 has always been my favorite year because, to me, my very first lowrider was when I got an Impala, you know. When I got a 63 Impala, my neighbor sold it to me. He was always bringing cars back from Kansas and stuff, you know. And I think I bought it for like $3,000, a hardtop, and I did it up, you know. And it was rough, you know, but like I said, it was, you had to hustle your way through it because that's what you wanted. So you ran after it, you know?
Yeah.
And I think of all people, if I've done it, anyone could do it because, you know, I grew up with nothing, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I made it happen. So I think everybody can make it happen.
You just got to put the effort.
Oh yeah. If you want something, you're going to fucking grind and you're going to go get it, you know?
Straight up. That's a good PSA, man.
For sure, man. I mean, you just got to get off the fucking couch and grind, man.
And grind, fucking, yeah.
Buy low, sell high, and fucking, it works out, you know?
Oh, yeah, definitely. So how many cars do you own, bro? And just kind of let me know the years and stuff like that.
You know what? I kind of lost count, you know? It's kind of a bad thing, but a good thing at the same time. But I pretty much almost have all the Impalas, the good years that I consider. But I love them all, honestly. But, you know, and sometimes it's too much and it's overwhelming. But like I said, it's like I don't choose to live in the biggest house on the block, on the hill or nothing. And I got my priorities right. I pay my bills first and all that stuff. And I'm blessed to have a, you know, understanding better half that, you know, kind of gives me free reins, you know, as long as everything else, all the priorities are handled, you know?
And that helps a lot, bro. Having a woman that supports you.
For sure.
In your business or your car, yep. Anything. Yep. And then, you know, vice versa. You support
her. Not only that, yeah. And willing to go cruise with me. Willing to go,
yeah.
You know, freaking 1,000 miles to go cruise somewhere or something, you know?
Yeah.
Or to pick up a car, or pick up parts, or to sell a car, you know?
Mm-hmm. Hey, bro, what was one special moment taking the 6-1 out of town? What state? What was the Elysian Park or something? What has been, like, super inspiring for you, bro, where you felt like, man, I finally did it, you know what I'm saying? And you're out here rolling with the big dogs and just enjoying it. And your car's right there, you know, in the mix.
You know, I have several. Like, my two favorite places to go is Phoenix, you know? Phoenix and LA for sure, just because that's where it's at, and that's where it's like the caliber of cars is something else, you know. It's like you don't see no junk up, you know, they're constantly like on top of their shit. And I'm gonna say though, memorable is like I used to love Tolleson. They stopped doing that in Arizona. Cruising through Tolleson was beautiful, man.
Mm-hmm.
Frank's Hydraulics, we've done every year. We met a nice group of friends there that we go hang out with every year. Cece and Julian and Slow Lane Car Club out there. They just always invite us with open arms and make us feel at home. And we had a lot of fun out there, man.
Yeah.
You know, Josh from High Class.
Mm-hmm.
We've met a lot of people out there, you know, and we have fun.
Yeah. Yeah, you too. It's cool to see you, man, because I looked on Instagram and I was like, damn, homeboy's over there.
Yeah.
You know, he's in Cali, he's in Arizona.
Yeah, it's shit dope. We do like every year, you know, and we look forward to it. And it's like, man, this is dope, you know?
Yeah, definitely. So, bro, who would you like to give a special thanks to? Somebody who's always been there, supported you the whole way.
As far as cars or?
As far as life, bro.
You know what? I want to thank God. I want to thank my parents. God, first of all. I wouldn't do this without him. My parents, my better half, my wife, my kids, you know, always understanding, always rolling with me. Brothers, sisters, you know. And I want to thank, you know, my employees here. Everybody that helps me out, you know, I'm sure I'm missing a lot of names. Everyone that out of state that helps out, just everyone really in my life, you know.
Yeah, that's what's up, bro. It's a big list. And you got it a lot of support. It is a big list,
and I could keep going, you know.
Yeah, definitely, bro.
You know all the homies that you know, all the bigger homies that you know used to take me out when I didn't have a car, you know, and build memories with cruising, and was like, fuck, man, I want to do that shit someday, you know?
Yeah, straight up. And then now you're that guy doing it.
It's yeah. And it's awesome, you know?
Yeah. One last word, of any advice to some younger person in, you know, just starting out? What's the advice to give them?
Don't give up and reach for the sky and keep reaching, because to me, everybody's like, oh, you're successful, you're successful. I never call myself successful, because I think that somebody successful keeps reaching, you know? So I think just keep reaching for the sky, you know, just keep reaching. I think someone that has a lot of hustle and drive, they just keep reaching and they stay reaching, you know? They never really get there because once you get something you want, you keep going, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Just keep going. You're going to fall. You're going to lose. You're going to get pissed off. You're going to cry. But the most important is just keep fucking, keep reaching. Yeah, reaching for the sky, you know?
Yeah.
Fall down, get up, keep going. You know? Yeah.
That's what's up, bro. Some great words, man.
Yeah, and never take shortcuts. Like, do the shit that makes you happy, you know, and buy the shit that makes you happy, because we only live once in this life.
Yeah,
you know?
Straight up.
We gotta enjoy the shit, you know?
Yeah. And I want to send something out to some of these people who have nice cars. Get those cars out. Take them out. Cruise them.
For sure. Me too, yeah.
You know?
Yeah, enjoy
them. Get out there, because we're only on limited time here. Yeah. So you gotta take advantage of
every moment. Yeah, we only live once, and you know what? I always tell people, you know, it's like cooking a perfect steak, you know, on the grill, and this one came out nice, you know? I'm sure everybody that grills or whatever knows it. But say you cook the perfect steak, and you don't eat it ever, you know? Fuck no, I cooked the perfect steak, I'm gonna eat that shit, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm gonna try to get it right the next time, better than that one, you know?
Yeah, straight up.
So I just think that you should take out your car. You should build it to enjoy it, because when you're building it to put in a show, I feel like you're asking everybody else's approval for it, you know? And you know, I like to build my cars a certain way because that's how I like them, you know? I like to make them look like they did from the factory, but Lowrider, sometimes people start chasing those points and start putting stuff on their cars that they would never put on there, you know?
Yep.
Just to gain a point here and a point there. For what? To get a, you know, $10 trophy you took home?
Yeah.
Man, I'm not into that, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, I see people tearing their displays down, working hard as fuck, you know? But they're not eating the steak. They're not enjoying it after. They're not on the boulevard, you know?
Yeah, yeah. No, that's one of
them. They put their shit in a trailer and go to the hotel and probably crash because they done put fucking 500 meters away, you know? And,
yeah.
And fucking sometimes go home upset because this guy beat him because he knew that guy or whatever. And just do it for yourself and enjoy the shit, you know?
Exactly. That's 100.
And get out there and drive that shit and have fun with your family, because that's where the memories are made, you know?
Yep. That's 100, man.
For sure.
That's 100. Adrian, thanks again, bro, for letting us come to your shop, hang out with you, check out all the badass rides. And I appreciate what you're doing in Colorado, bro, making, you know, pushing that movement and doing what you're doing.
Yeah, you're always welcome, man. Anytime.
Thank you, bro. And with that being said, we'd like to thank you for tuning in and joining us for another episode. Please tune in next week for another episode of A Badass Ride from Colorado. Please like, subscribe, and hit that notification button so you know when we drop videos.